And now the anthem of Cameroon. Indisa Cameroon himni.
Thank you. six shot for Cameroon. His first touch of the ball.
Free kick in the end.
captain, Captain Kibanek. Boak takes it into his own hands and finds Pierre Malong. He finds Colin Malolo, gets a shot away, and it takes a deflection too. Had to be lively in goal, did Marwan Ahmadou, it was.
Yeah. Indeed.
dispossessed. Canal. Strokes play to the left. Sal Megbas. Back to Canal. He's for himself. Before I kill him. Back to the over to the left, but Liverpool danger of finding his man there. Foul in the process. Referee Nagayev goes over. Top to Cano. Doesn't go. Goal runs to Nils. Had to cross it back in. And that pass was there, but Nils had good control. So Cano not having it all the wrong way in his opening 20 minutes here at the Azure Arena. Certainly not very capable of scoring through the indomitable lines. So slightly down the way back. Cano is in there again. Looking to use his height. Lean out of Tanga now. Tries to find Pangok again, which he does brilliantly. Pangok leaves the ball behind him. So back to Lean out of Tanga. Sergio Colomino is on his near side, crying for the ball. But it does come as well. Right at the back to Nico Bellino. This is for Nicola Singardi, who has drawn Sarajevo's goalkeeper out of his area. Dangerous play that. But it worked out. Showing off match practice this season with Al Haraldo. And appearances for his club. Still hasn't really got on the end of anything in this match, the front man for Cameroon. And Tango again. Safe into the clutches this time with Mara Ahadari. Foot. stable himself before keeping possession through his defence. And Jami again. Intercepted back by Jean Perrin. Shocking ball to the right for Nicola Malolo. Has a Lima Tango near him. He goes himself to Nicola Malolo. Brilliant play from Nicola Malolo. Looks to put in a cross as well. It's far too far for the striker, but it's followed up well. And Adolu Serge was coming onto that and put a shot away. Lovely play from Nicola Malolo. Showed his box of tricks down the right hand side. And across. Bad, but it just wasn't in the area it needed to be. Five shorter. Dylan Cole and some runs. Kevin had a chance for a goal there, but from the kick, so now headed down, headed over the top. Oh, they're going close now. Cameroon turns off. Opportunity there, and you see why the yellow card was given for handball in the end. And perhaps knowing what he was doing with his hand there, and so deserving a yellow card for that. Malolo to the ball. To Junko, who finds Nicola Malolo, almost finds it. Plays red. Winning a free kick. This is Alamri's box of tricks on this play. Alamri, so he was number 15, and the other players in the side at 23. Ages. 20 years and 8 minutes. Cameroon's average age, another over it, 22 and 2 months. Some experience with the African side here. Now, how cool I could have stayed forward, dispossessed by Navizo. Certainly both sides really come into play in this one. Nicola Malolo now latches onto this. He has a bit of space to work his magic. Cut against the penalty area. He has Miguel Larsson, Gani with him. Pangok's there too. Pangok now taking it forward. Looks for a bit of space himself and pulls it back. Nicola Malolo. Can he get a shot away? He can, but to no effect whatsoever. Fine build-up play from Cameroon. But the less of the bat, the first, the better. And the hard stuff for Sergio Cameroon. Finally on to start things now. Started the first match. match against Azerbaijan to become a little bit. Only put one of his four shots on goal on target. Played football being dropped in the second match against Morocco. Started well in this game. And perhaps needs to sharpen up with his shooting boots.
Number 10, you are ready?
You are ready. That's a Zahin. Abukawi to Kano. No one was there for Saudi Arabia's captain. Started every game for Saudi Arabia, did Mohamed Kano at the AFC under 23 championships in Qatar last year. It's a fact. Really sad here through some difficult circumstances in this tournament. Now picking the ball up. He's going to Apollo Malola, who does get another shot in, and it's blocked this time. Back for a corner. Pangop lines up to take this one. Pangop, Franz Pangop switching play from left to right. Causing problems for Saudi Arabia's defence. Pierre Malong positions himself in the centre of the penalty area. Ball comes in. Headed onto it by Matthew Banyak. Mohamed Dahl looks for options as some bit of rain comes down here in the Azza Arena. Free kick again, Alki Wakili this time, getting taken to the ground. Youssef Ndar makes a whistle. His nation ranked 52 in FIFA's rankings. Cameroon, a little bit higher at 33. Of course, it doesn't mean much at under 23 level. Saudi Arabia in attack again. Al-Alami finds Kano. Puts in the cross, blocked by Banyak, who chases it back to try and stop it from going for a corner, but can't. Trudging over to place this one down. Ali Lajani, the right back, is in there. Certain height on the side of the Saudi Arabians here. Kano comes off his back. And Megbas, the number 7 for Saudi Arabia, chasing this back down, but Ali Mutinde gets his head to it. This is Pangop on the far side. Cutting here, he has Malone with him. Malone finds Alimo Tango. Kola Malolo is in the penalty area. Goes himself. Heavy clash. And referee instantly calls over the medics. Looks like both players have banged heads. Might be something more sinister in it, the way Mohamed Kino seized up after that clash. Referee Agaev stopped play immediately to call over the medics when he saw what happened. Both players almost to a man. Indeed, they are to a man. They've come over to see how both their respective players are. So it was a nasty clash of heads. Both players have come out from some. The way he lay on the ground so hard, like he'd come off worse out of the clash. Now, serious scenes here at the Azul Arena. Also for the welfare of both players as Maki Banyak went into the side of Mohamed Kano. You have to say he was possibly knocked out instantly in the air, which only made things worse as he fell. You have to say you can see from that angle how close by the medics are. Both sets of players are receiving the best treatment possible. Maki Banyak is released on his feet. Now walking over towards the dugout. Lying on the stretcher, ready to be transported off. Well, very sad scenes here. At the end of the night, Mohamed Kino looks to be rushed off for urgent treatment. And thoughts are with him. Jumping for the ball. And Yusuf Anbar, well, his worries about his team's performance out the window whilst he sees his captain stretch it off. Certainly, you have to say both sets of players sure to be affected by that, and Mohamed Kano's condition certainly looked to be serious, and the serious nature was understood instantly by referee Aliyar Agiev as he pulled the medics over, and the medics in turn instantly arrived. So gingerly, for both sides, thoughts turn back to playing. Saudi Arabia not yet brought on a substitute for their captain. They play on in this match with a slightly subdued tone now here at the Azul Arena, following what we've just seen. For both sets of players, we do hope they are okay. Saudi Arabia in possession. Dowry. Now this is being threaded through to Akola Malolo, who latches onto this. This is a chance for Akola Malolo. Chips over him. Goal line save, but the header goes up to follow him. Has it gone in? The referee indicates that it has. Cameroon celebrates. They are 1-0 up here on 38 minutes. And it came through Akola Malolo, the most dangerous man in the side. And it looks to have gone to Ngolo Osungani, who was on hand to head in. Important goal for the Indomitable Lions. They've all just had an extended break in play from an injury to two players. But it's Cameroon who have taken the initiative following that. Akola Malolo did well to stay on his feet and get a shot away. Super head away. But then, like all good centre forwards, Denny Nicola Osungani was on hand. Although it didn't hit the net, well, if we've seen him after all, they've got him. Pierre Malone now on the strike. Oh, he's a danger man when he gets into areas like that. Working in the tango. John Coe. Ball coming back to Alina Matanga. And now the ball comes in again over the goal scorer, Nicola Osungani. And Alina has a chance to break, but intercepted by Bowak. Malone on the ball, deciding where to play his team in. Goes to Jonko. Now Bowak, he may cross from here. Intercepted, and John Coe strikes it, and now it skim away, it didn't quite it. Came back in line with Marwan Hadari, I'll be grateful for that. So that goal giving Cameroon now a real chance of qualifying for the knockout stages. Building, of course, on what's happening in today's other match between Azerbaijan and Morocco. Hello, now picks this up. That other match of concern to no other players on the pitch at the moment. Ngolo Osungani was offside. Hadn't had all that much to do in this first half, Ngolo Osungani. He'd made himself busy, made himself available, but the ball just hadn't come his way until that moment. He got a knock on the head to ensure that he put his team one up. It's a nice ball. Now, rather remarkably, Cameroon's captain, Niki Banyak, who's involved in a sickening clash of heads with Mohamed Kamara just about 6 minutes ago, is back on, strapping around his head. Unfortunately, the same point was said of Mohamed Kamara, who we believe has been taken to hospital. And play stops here as Marwan Hadari is now on the floor here. Not entirely sure why. And we're going to play forwards. His team on the shot. Off the bang, that's pretty. A nice bump. Back on.
بالنسبه يدخل 10.
Substitution for the national team of Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia stanowi wielka komanda sędzia Dida Lejiri. Player out. With a match of
substitution.
Number 18. To reset is Mohamed Khadlo. Player 8. On the visit is number 9. Mugadokus.
Azurahan Al-Ghazi.
Okay.
and now keep it in two. But that'll be half time. First half really defined by an injury, but since then, Cameroon reacted and have got a 2-goal lead, which they need if they are to qualify without any mathematical troubles into the semi finals. That was very happy their first half run. 2-0 here at the Azure Arena. Cameroon feel like the semi finals are in sight after Cameroon for Sporting. First half was very good for the referee. Agiev. Officiating over 22 players. Also, an incident involving captain Michael Banyak and Saudi Arabia's captain as well, Mohamed Kano, who we understand has been taken to hospital following that head injury. To replace him, Abdurrahman Gandhi for Saudi Arabia. He's finding his space here. Cameroon on the attack early. Cameroon picks the ball up. Good play from Saudi Arabia. Left field line. This is Gandhi now, the replacement for Kano. This possession was unlucky there. Now Pierre Long on the surge. This possession by Hatton back to the end. That's Cameroon as enforcer.
Surge. So Lima Tango, Cameroon 2.
find themselves, create some space for themselves to go back. That's always a good source of excitement for Cameroonian fans when he gets the ball. Set up both goals indirectly. Strike from long range by Jean Carlos. Offside the fencing here, even at that time, not challenging the keeper at all. The 18-year-old scoring in this one for his country. Represents a Cameroon under 17 and under 20s level now, making a name for himself at under 20 players.
Allez, 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 allez
take the ball was caught.
Despite the fact that in the build-up to this match, head coach Richard Tower
Kotete relinquishes charge of the side. Taken to fly back tomorrow for medical reasons. Standing head coach Kesak Mabarang must be delighted with what he's seen today. Took their time to get up and running to Cameroon, but once they have, they've hit their straps and got amongst the goals. To the credit, Saudi Arabia haven't made it easy at all. They pose questions of themselves too, Saudi Arabia. Be a female at leg pass, and yet coolly dispossesses it. Champions in 2005, they followed up an exhibition of results and down to games in Indonesia, reaching the semi-finals. Here's one of the semis, they have taken the bronze medal match and lost that one 2-1. Another decent record in this tournament, but it just hasn't worked for them here.
Side.
And braces Michael. jam.
Place, Junior Dande.
lining up. And I saw that in minute 19, time 19 just before the tournament, Jimmy Dando, despite being the understudy, 2 months older than Amasola. It's his chance in this match. Surely nothing to read into that substitution. Now we can piss up another one wanting to win the changes of people seem fresh for the next round. Save from Junior Danda. He's only just come on. He had to be lively there, and he was. Great ball in from Akira Kibble. And it was Agandi who'd stolen him at the far post. Most definitely should have done better from that range, but credit Junior Danda for staying strong. Oh, The Chinese quality back here makes a quality.
Since he's coming.
Peter and the way he likes it. I thought he did, and that's right, to bring the ball back on the far side. But free kick given to Cameron. They're throwing down to the other two, Cameron. They haven't come off Saudi Arabia. Ubiobi again, can they let that ball bounce off it? Banyata backwards, but cleared up well by Obazi. Second ball was on the pitch, just to confuse things. Piano, burst of speed to find himself some space. Serge, poor pass down the left. Attempted to pan it up, but never in the danger of finding it. Kiwi Kibi comes forward. Now Al Alamri has stolen into the box with the ball. Full stop by Banya. Gandhi has to go back to Anarchy and Azazi. The situation at Bayo between Azerbaijan and Morocco is extremely narrow. So as things stand, Azerbaijan and Cameroon will be qualifying out of this group for the semi-finals. Saudi Arabia and Morocco heading out. Americas. Now Malcolm. Again, now Amarcus. Akira Kibi. Come near this. Now Akira Kibi saw some space for himself. Shoots himself. Great shot. Junior Dambe up to it. Finally, Saudi Arabia bare their teeth. That was a nice bit of play. Nice shot, too, from Akira Kibi. I mentioned that shots on goal would come from him. Now, did on that occasion. Zahir shot as a blocked. Inside here, no one near him. character since he's come on. There he picks up the yellow card, having run 10 yards to arrive and put in a late tackle. I understand his frustration at getting this outcome as well, and when it has, he's had several Reading players on the overhead. But Tom Reading's frustrations show. Into the final 3 minutes of this match. The final 3 minutes of Saudi Arabia's tournament. Cameroon after this will be competing in their semi-final at the Dalga Arena. They'll have to reintroduce themselves to a grass pitch up there. It's not actually far away from the Azal Arena at all, but different surface and a different challenge for all their teams to have to get used to. Biobi provides a positive input on the game, letting that ball on for Pangop. But didn't find any end. Akira Kibi, the amount of yards Akira Kibi has covered in this game, it's been up there. It's the highest of the players on the pitch. There's so much running, the number 10 for Saudi Arabia. Final substitution for Saudi Arabia before the time is up. Fahad Zahin will be coming off to be replaced by Hassan Rafali. Simpson, the fact that Cameroon have sat back and attacked as much as they did in that first half. And Apollo Morelli is very much to the fore. Just 18 years of age, plays for the Dragon Di Yaoundé club in Cameroon. Surely a bright future ahead of him. I feel like he'll be again showing his ability, but losing the ball, Pierre Malone. Trudges forward with it. Akola Malolo. Someone in the lane for Nima. And he loses possession there. Most exciting attacking moment Cameroon have had for some time, right? Which says much more about their approach than that to this final half hour. Good voice all game. So we can't fit their performance over the last half hour as Akula Kibi puts a shot away. Over the bar and frustrating one for him. 3 minutes of time added on. Oh, so really stand-up performance, really, I have to say. Possibly the stand-up performer. And then with Akula Kibi. Himself in an attacking capacity, and I have to say Mohamed Kino as well, Saudi Arabia's captain, has been to the fore. Kino, of course, going off in a sickening clash of heads in the first half with Ricky Bandu. Still haven't heard any news on his situation, but he was taken to hospital. And the medics were on site as quickly as could be possible, so for looking all too serious for Mohamed Kino, but that very nasty clash of heads. And most certainly Kino was knocked out. Saudi Arabia's performance after that certainly dipped in the interim and then allowed Cameroon to score two quick-fire goals. Turning around at half-time with a 2-0 lead, the indomitable lot. Lions really didn't look back from there. Third goal coming from a super strike from Mickey Banyak from the corner. As Mabiobi tries to get a hair on that. Panga takes the ball off Alcoa Kibbe, who takes it back. Good tussle from the two number 10s out. Thomas Bawak now, foraging down his right-hand side. Samuel Mulend picks the ball up. We have Mabiobi in the centre. Great skill to get out of a tight spot there from Alan Henry. Agandi now. And Al Megas. They keep knocking on the door to Saudi Arabia. No goals in this tournament yet. Can the final minutes of time in Iran be the moment? But they do break their deadlock. Fall into the ground here. As they do it on the forehead. You have to say, it won't happen. Try as they might, Saudi Arabia, they have drawn a blank here against Cameroon, who have sauntered into the semi-finals with a 3-0 victory. Goals coming from Ngolo Osungani, from Panga, and Banyak